Fletcher County Regional Airport Development and Diversification on Initiative has been in the works for several years, trying to come up with the almost $4.5 million needed to get public water access for the airport and the surrounding community. NewsWatch reporter Anna Saunders was at the airport today when Governor Jim Justice came to present the remainder of the money needed.
The Mercer County Airport now has the funding to get access to public water, but the access won't just stop here.
The project will increase access to reliable and clean water for area residents and businesses to improve the economic development potential of the regional airport, a critical economic asset in the region. The project will serve 75 new customers, including 10 businesses.
The Mercer County Airport has been using well water since it opened in the 50s.
We currently have two wells at the airport. Both wells produce very little water, and if you run the water for about 30 minutes, the well will be dry for 24 hours.
And on Tuesday, Governor Jim Justice came to recommend a $250,000 transfer from the Appalachian Regional Commission to the project to give the airport and the surrounding community the money it needed to get public water.
It's 2019. Should we not have water to our people or sewage to our people? Well, of course we should. But the reality is just this. We didn't have any money. We didn't have any money to do anything.
Justice credited surplus and an increase in investments in West Virginia as the reasoning behind why the state can now come up with the money. And the water pipe that will be put in will also service other parts of the county.
Also a part of this project is extending the water up Route 52 towards Bluefield to get to the top of the mountain there. There's buildings and businesses there that will also benefit from new water, and that higher elevation will get the water pressure to here and everywhere in the project.
Reporting in Bluefield, I'm Anna Saunders, NewsWatch.
Those involved with the project say the construction contracts will need to be signed, and it won't be long before construction begins along Route 52.